What do all these happenings have in common? They all involve decimals. But then, you probably use decimals every day. Do you know when? Well, every time you buy something, you're using decimals. And since decimals are based on tens, we can write them as an extension of our base 10 counting system. This makes them easy to write and easy to use. You remember that decimals often serve the same purpose as fractions. For example, the fraction 3/10 can also be written this way. Now it becomes a decimal. The fraction 36/100 can also be written as a decimal. In a numeral such as 9 36/100, we combine a whole number and a decimal. Or we might have a numeral such as 1,316 254 thousandths. With decimals, we're just extending our base 10 counting system to the right of the decimal point. Do you remember the place value names in a number like this? Starting with the first place on the left, they are the thousands place, hundreds place, tens place, ones place. And continuing with the first place on the right of the decimal point, they are the tenths place, the hundredths place, the thousandths place, and so on. Notice that as we move to the left, each place, both whole number and decimal, is 10 times the value of the preceding place. And as we move to the right, each place, both whole number and decimal, is 1/10 the value of the preceding place. So when you measure something down to 1/1000th of a meter, that's a very small amount. It may be a more accurate measurement than you really need. So you can round off the decimal by dropping one or more digits on the right. If the last digit on the right is less than 5, we just drop that last digit. But if the last digit is 5 or more, we drop it and add 1 to the next digit to the left. Now let's think of an example how this might be useful. Say your class was experimenting with some plant fertilizers. You were growing plants in several different pots. Each week, a class member measured the plants to see how much they had grown. You kept careful records of these measurements, but some students made their measurements to the thousandths place, and some made them to the hundredths place. If plant C measured 176 thousandths of a meter at the second week, and it measured 25 hundredths of a meter the third week, how much did it grow in the week between the measurements? How do we find the amount it grew? By subtracting, of course. Here's a situation in which it would be useful to round off the longer decimal to the same length as the shorter one. So how do you round off the longer decimal? If we make sure the decimal points are lined up one above the other, then the places will be properly lined up for subtraction. Now we can subtract, just as we do with whole numbers. The remainder is 7. But is it 7/10? 7/100? 7/1000? Well, let's make an estimate of what our remainder should be. This will tell us where the decimal point should go. Now think about the original problem. we're subtracting 18 hundredths of a meter from 25 hundredths of a meter. So there should be a few hundredths of a meter left over. Our plant grew 7 hundredths of a meter in 1 week. In addition and subtraction, the decimal point in the answer always goes directly under the decimal points above it. Now let's consider another situation that involves using decimals. Suppose you're the keeper of this wildlife sanctuary. You're responsible for the care and feeding of the many different birds that live here. It's hard work, but if you like birds, it's well worth the effort. One problem is, each of the different kinds of birds eats different foods. For example, the ducks and geese seem to like bread and lettuce. But the pelicans prefer fish. The flamingos seem to like shrimp. The swans tend to like corn and grain. And this old crane will eat just about anything it can catch. Now, here's your problem. How much does it cost each day to feed all of these different birds? This is what you need for their daily feeding program. A loaf of bread which costs 69 cents. 2 heads of lettuce, which cost about 95 cents. 1 kilogram of fish, which costs about $2.25. And 1 kilogram of corn, which costs about 60 cents. If we add all these amounts together, we should know about how much it costs to feed the birds each day. First, make sure the decimal points are lined up one above the other. And we're ready to add. You know how to add whole numbers, so we won't go through the process. But can you look at these figures and make a rough estimate of what the sum will be? Something more than $1 and less than $10? Something between $4 and $5. Let's see now. If we add in the usual way, that estimate will help you decide where the decimal point should go. And it's a good way to check the figures in your final answer, too. $4.49. But wait a minute. We forgot the tax. A 5.5% sales tax. The percent sign means per hundred. So our tax will be 5.5 cents on every 100 cents, or each dollar, of our purchase. Can you write 5.5 cents as a decimal? Well, we know 5 cents is written as 5 hundredths. How would you write 1/2 cent in decimals? To find 1/2 of 1 hundredth, we would divide 1 hundredth by 2. And when we divide 1 hundredth by 2, we find it's 5 thousandths. So if 1/2 a cent is written as 5 thousandths, then 5.5 cents would be written 55 thousandths. In the store, they'd probably use the cash register or a calculator to work out the tax on your purchase. A calculator is a very handy instrument for doing complicated calculations, but it can't think for you. You have to know what the figures mean and why you're doing what you're doing. to find the tax, you'd multiply 4 49/100 by 55,000, which gets a little complicated. Look at the product. Can you tell what your tax will be? Well, since we're talking about money, we can round these figures off to two places. And we don't need to start at the right end. We can start at the thousandth place. You can see you'll have to add 25 cents tax to the total of your purchase. Now let's review the ideas we've worked on today about decimals. Adding or subtracting decimals is like adding or subtracting whole numbers. You can make sure the place values are lined up one above the other by making sure the decimal points are lined up one above the other. The decimal point in the sum, or remainder, goes directly below the decimal points above. A good way to be sure the decimal point in the answer will be in the right place is to estimate what your result should be. And you can round off decimal places when you have more digits than you need. If the figure you're going to drop is less than 5, you just drop it. But if it's 5 or more, you drop it and add 1 in the next place to the left. Decimals are used in many different places every day. We use them in all our money transactions. We use decimals in percents. We use them in the metric system of measurement. See if you can find some other uses of decimals at home, at school, or any place you go. Now let's see, was there anything else? We also did some multiplying and dividing with decimals when we calculated the tax on food for our birds. But these birds are getting hungry. They're more interested in food than they are in decimals. So we'd better feed them now and leave multiplication and division for another time. Say your class was experimenting with some plant fertilizers. You were growing plants in several different pots. Each week, a class member measured the plants to see how much they had grown. You kept careful records of these measurements, but some students made their measurements to the thousandth place, and some made them to the hundredth place. Say your class was experimenting with some plant fertilizers. You were growing plants in several different pots. Each week, a class member measured the plants to see how much they had grown. You kept careful records of these measurements, but some students made their measurements to the thousandth place, and some made them to the 100th place.